Hello, it's PolishPolVR, welcome to my channel, and today we're gonna do different kind of video as it's the third anniversary of PlayStation VR. We're gonna talk a bit about the future. This video is inspired by the latest patent of the new headset. Well, so we think new headset, but of course, as always, patents means nothing. There is plenty of patents, but what I want to do is talk a bit about some games that possibly might be coming to PlayStation 5 with PSVR support, but this video is based heavily on rumors and most of them games are not confirmed, just a little list. I try to keep two games from the developers that mention doing it in VR, maybe on the future generations. Now, I touched a bit about the patents, let's play some in the background, some pictures. As you can see, there's tons and tons of patents for the controllers. You know, Move controllers, as we know, are a bit shitty, they still doing their job. For me, tracking is good enough, my biggest issue is no thumbstick, but as you can see in the background when I mentioned earlier patents means nothing, you can see it now how many different patents for Move controllers there was. There was detachable DualShock, which splits into two moves. Also there is some like even hand tracking or finger tracking, the legs, the one you can put on legs and I don't know, roll around the room, I don't know, I suppose it's something like Vive Tracker. Just tons and tons of these different designs. As you can see, Sony tries different things, just like all the companies. They patenting stuff all the time, so maybe one of those patents is the future Move controllers, or maybe it's not and it's gonna be something totally different. Who knows? But once again, patents are just here for you to enjoy, good for views, good for clicks, but not so good for the predicting the future. In the end, back in the day, if you remember this little plastic wheel when you put your Move controller on PS3 and it's pretended to be a wheel for the games, that's people used to think that's gonna be the controller for PS4. That's how much rumors are spreading. So like I said, the latest patent of the headset, now we've got headset patents in the background, doesn't mean that much at all. Sony patented some other headset, some lighthouse tracking system, as well as augmented reality glasses and stuff. And of course it was heavily featured everywhere because like I said, clicks and views are always good for everyone. For me and for other channels and the outlets out there on the internet. But like I said, might be a bit of truth in those patents, or it might be just something totally different, but it's nice to look and it's nice to see what Sony is working on, what they patenting. You can see that they definitely trying a different things. But now we've got that out of way, we're gonna start speaking about some games, like I mentioned before, based on the rumors, but also we've got few confirmed games that we know it's gonna be coming to PS5 with PSVR support. And speaking about PS5 and PSVR, if you don't know, let me just let you know that your current headset will work with PlayStation 5. You cannot expect PSVR 2 anytime soon. I'm assuming maybe 2 years minimum, so we're gonna have to stick with that one, but maybe we're gonna get some new controllers, who knows, nobody knows. And also I heard that PlayStation 5 gonna have built-in capabilities for PSVR, which means maybe we might not have to use the breakout box anymore, but like I said, rumors are not always true. Anyway, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like because it does helps the channel a lot, and if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe, it's always better when it's more of us. Okay, let's talk about some games. But remember, like I said, this is nothing 100% confirmed, many of it is based on the rumors, but I chose the game in which the developers did interviews with various publications and mentioned PSVR or VR in the future. So first game is Chernobyl Light. Now this is possibility of it happening, probably not that great. Coming from Farm 51, the developers of Chernobyl VR Experience, which many people enjoyed, still out on the store, very cheap and actually quite fun to just learn. But during this experience they actually 3D scanned many areas of the Chernobyl and they using them into this game. In past they released Get Even game and it was quite a good game. They wanted to bring it to PSVR as well, they actually even announced it, but towards the end of the development they basically said we cannot do it. But this company definitely knows a lot of VR, and I'm speaking about Chernobyl Light because around a year ago in the interview with the Polish Polish publication Graczpospolita.pl, they mentioned that in the future they might add VR, maybe in the future generations, which is basically PlayStation 5. So it's something they're thinking of, the game releasing on Steam as early access very soon, but they kind of never mentioned VR since this one single interview. But saying that might happen, might not. For me, possibilities of this happening are very, very little, as the Chernobyl Light seems like a very complicated and demanding game, but also saying that PSVR on PS5 should have enough power to run demanding games as well. We just don't know exact specs of PlayStation 5, but we know it's gonna be a big leap. Chernobyl Light is a science fiction survival horror experience, so it's a very scary game apparently. It's a free exploration kind of game, so the world is quite big, there is crafting, there is combat as well. The game is absolutely non-linear, so you kind of be able to make a bit of your adventure. And of course it's all taking place in the real exclusion zone in Chernobyl. Like I mentioned, releasing very soon as early access on PC, it's actually 2 days away, releasing on 16th of October. Very good studio, Getiver was great. I wonder maybe if they've been working on VR version for Getiver, maybe that will come, I don't know. But anyway, looking at the recommended specs for the game for PC, you need a Core i7, 16 gigs of RAM, GTX 160. So yeah, I don't know, maybe possible, maybe not. They saying the game should run in those specs at least 30 frames per second on high settings or 60 FPS on medium. I don't know, maybe it's gonna happen, maybe not. Probably not, but even though, you know, I want to talk about it. We're having fun today, it's 3 years of PlayStation VR, we're looking in the future, so we're mentioning some games. But anyway, let's move on to something else, which is Dreams. Now, we know that VR coming for this game, so this is 100% confirmed, but lately Sony's boss did an interview and he said for him Dreams is a 10-year project. And when he says that, to me it sounds like maybe VR might not come in anytime soon, especially that the game is still in early access, only early access game on PlayStation, by the way. The game, that is great, but 10 years from now on, maybe we're gonna get VR, who knows. I'm assuming in PlayStation 4, I don't want to spread any false rumor, but I can't see the VR happening anytime this generation, so my best guess is that Dreams will receive PSVR support on PlayStation 5 when they've got more power to play with. They already been speaking about VR mode and they've been saying that you're gonna have to kind of optimize it, you're gonna have to play through the game and see where it's work, what works, what's not. I think the game gonna tell you like, listen, you cannot put this in the VR, get ready, make it better, spend some time with it. But like I said, Sony's boss saying it's 10 years project and 10 years is a long time, so a lot of things might happen, but for me VR might happen next generation. And speaking about the Dreams, this game is amazing. I like to every day check out some videos and see what people created, and they're getting better and better at it. When VR support drops, we can expect amazing things. Next game is Everspace 2. I spoke about it in my news video lately. Everspace is a very, very good looking, promising looter shooter in space. The world is totally free to you for you to explore. An open world space shooter with tons of rewards, tons of loot, tons of side missions and stuff, and just very busy game with millions of things for you to do. Speaking about Everspace, the first one got VR support, and actually when they was asked about PlayStation VR version, they said they could not bring first one to PSVR due to PS4 original. The power was just not there. They said they tested it and there was like not a chance. With Everspace 2, which is currently in Kickstarter as well, in their FAQ section of the Kickstarter page, they provide us with a bit of information about PlayStation VR version. And basically what they said, they cannot promise anything, definitely not for this gen, but for the next gen they might do PSVR version of this game, but they're saying it will be a separate purchase because they would have to rework UI and everything. And I think that's the great idea, because at least it would allow them to make more money, and maybe they're gonna bring Everspace 1 to PSVR PSVR, maybe on PS5, who knows? They got VR version ready now, so they can just make another sale and make some money, especially that I'm hearing that the game is good. Now let's speak a bit about GT Sport. Now this is another rumored, nothing confirmed, but we saw the gameplay from GT Sport played on PlayStation VR with the enemies around you, which basically looked like it's a full version in the virtual reality. As we know, when the game released, we knew that it's only like a side mode for PSVR. You still get to race on all the tracks and try all the cars, but you cannot race with enemies, with your opponents. And it looks like the version that we saw before with all the cars on the track was running on the PlayStation 4 Pro. So I'm wondering if Pro got enough power to run the full game in VR, maybe when the PlayStation 5 releases. Maybe this game gonna get little update, which gonna allow us to play full game in VR. GT Sport is a long project, it's a game that keeps getting update. It seems like this game gonna be live for a while, and of course we know PlayStation 5 will have backwards compatibilities with PlayStation 4, so we'll be able to play PS4 games on PS5, and they said some of them will be enhanced, and I wonder if one of the enhancements will be full-fledged VR mode for this game. That would be awesome. Now another game, and this is confirmed game, and this is actually game that might come to PlayStation 4 VR anyway, but there is a possibility that it might be PS5 launch title. This is a Honor and Duty steampunk. We don't have much footage of it, just this little teaser, but the developer said it's going to be another awesome Honor and Duty game. In the Honor and Duty D-Day, it's pretty much all multiplayer. They're getting ready to release single player DLC, but in this one from the get-go there will be heavy focus on the single player as well. But also there will be multiplayer with up to 64 players, which is awesome. And of course Honor and Duty is one of those games which are very cheap but also very fun. And last but not least, Lo-Fi, a game that was announced during Upload's VR E3 showcase, and pretty much people really like it from what they seen. Then the developers took to Kickstarter and they managed to get all the funding for the game. It's a futuristic game happening like a cyberpunk world. You're in that city fighting crime, you can go on the wrong path as well and, you know, become a very bad person, but of course fighting crime is the meaning and the message. You going around the city solving the cases. Now the developer said that this game could run on PlayStation 4 now, but the only thing that's stopping them is lack of thumbsticks on the controllers. I'm assuming they said it's only controllers that stops them, and I know many people might say there is plenty of games that got smooth locomotion with just without thumbstick, but some developers just don't do things like that because they might think it's gonna compromise their game. We don't know what's happening and how many buttons it's gonna use, but definitely lack of thumbsticks holding PSVR back a bit, even though the developers found ways to get around it, and of course we all enjoying it. Those developers of Lo-Fi must see the serious reason why they cannot use the moves. So let's hope we get new controllers on PS5, because they definitely all up for bringing this to PlayStation VR. Okay, so there you have it. It's only 6 games, because I wanted to include games that was like kind of spoken about by developers. I didn't wanted to say, oh, Astrobot will be coming, you know, second one and all that stuff, because you can always speculate and it probably will happen. I wanted just to talk about the games when the developers like keeping VR in mind, let's say. And of course, as it's 3 years since PSVR released, happy birthday to PlayStation VR. Hope you all enjoying it. And that's it, bye.